Hi everyone, I will talk about HTTP session in Servlet. Then what is HTTP session? It is used to maintain a state of an user. Why? Because the HTTP protocol is a stateless protocol. It doesn't maintain any state of an user. Then we use HTTP session to maintain a state of an user, which is used to store the information about the user. By seeing that information, the server can easily recognize that user is a old user or new user. See this diagram. There are two users send the request to the server. At that time, the server can create the session ID for each and every user. The session IDs are unique. By seeing the session ID, the server can easily recognize whether that user is a new user or old user. Then how do you implement the HTTP session in Servlet? Let me explain the code. This is index.html file. The form has been designed with username and password. The action equal to URL. This URL is nothing but a URL pattern has to be provided in the web.xml file. Then here input type equal to text. Enter email. Then input type equal to password. The form is consist of two fields. When you click on the login button, the data has to be sent to the server side application where the servlet can receive the data and create the session for each and every user. Then I will move on to the first servlet. In this application, we will receive the username and password from the HTML file. Then I want to create a session for the user. There is a class name HTTP session, the session object, the request.getSession. Or else if you true means the session is not been created for that user, the new session has to be created. Then session object.set attribute. The set attribute is consist of two arguments. It is a session name. It is a session value. The session name has been given as a user. The session value is username, which has been received from the HTML file. The username and password will be displayed on the browser. After that, session has created for the username. Then in this application, which receive the data from the HTML file and the session has to be created. The hyperlink have been created. When click on retrieve session, it has been redirected to the another servlet where we retrieve the session. Let me explain the code. In this application, we can able to retrieve the session which is already been created. Here the session object is created. Request.getSession false. False means no new session will be created. The session.get attribute, then session name is user. We have to get the session by using the session name. Then after that, the session.get ID, because unique ID have been created for each and every user. Then after that, session value will be displayed. That will be stored in the variable str. Then we can able to display the session value. Then after that, session create time, when the session have been created, then the method is the session object dot get creation time. Then last access time of the page, the method is get last access time, which will retrieve the time when you have visited the web page. Okay, this application has been used to retrieve the session which is already been created. Then I will run the application. Java C create session dot Java. Java C retrieve session dot Java. Here two files have been created. One is used for creating the session, another one is used for retrieve the session. Click on Manager app, then check your project name. My project name is HTTPSession1. The index file will get executed. Then you can able to enter the username and password, MADAR, then password 123456. Then click on login button. Then username is Madar. The password is 123456. The session created for Madar. Then we'll check it once whether session have been created or not. Click on application. Then click on cookies. See here, JSession ID. By using the HTTP session, we can able to create the session for the user. But session ID have been created. The session ID will be stored in the browser itself. But the original data will not be stored at the browser. The original data will be stored at the server. See here, the session ID have been created for that user. Then we retrieve the session. Then click on the retrieve session button. The session ID have been displayed for that user. The session value is Madar. When the session have been created, then 10/21. Okay, see here, the date is October 2. The session have been created. When you last access time, okay, 10/38. At this time, the session have been created. The second time we visited the page at 10/38. You can store the user information by using the HTTP session. If any doubt regarding this application, you can contact me through comment box. If you like this video, please subscribe my channel. Thank you all for watching my video.